If you remember the Tim Burton Batman movies from back in the day, Michael Keaton as Batman, amazing. You remember how cool that Batmobile was? One of our viewers reached out to me, wanted to show me the car that he's been working on in his garage for 4 years. He can't call it a Batmobile, but I gotta tell you, it's the closest thing I've ever seen to one. Check it out. Describe what we're looking at here.
A 22-foot, 5,000-pound, big black car.
The big black car.
Big black car.
Right. So tell me how this started, like putting this whole thing together.
My father and I have been building cars since I was in short pants. Started off with a GM A-body, typical of like Chevelles, and a Buick Skylark, and cut it, chopped it. And then built an entire frame underneath it. Stores the drivetrain. We got a 702 V12 in the front. We have a Boeing 502 jet engine in the back.
Where do you even go to get a jet engine? You can't just go down to like the auto parts place, right?
Just go to eBay, you know, and click buy it now. You know, and get the wife's permission. Car picks itself up and it'll spin 360. First car in the world to ever do that.
Your father, who worked on this with you, told me that was a complete nightmare to engineer.
It was.
Why?
Because of where the balance point in the car is. The balance point, in order to get the, because the only spot that we were able to even put something to make, be able to make it spin was up here near the firewall. And you got so much more of the car back here compared to what's little up front. The engine itself weighs almost 2,000 pounds, but it still wasn't enough to set the balance off right.
And what is that that actually comes down to do that?
It's a slewing ring. It's off of an excavator.
Wow.
And actually all of our gauges and switches actually do something. So you know, like, this is obviously ignition, start button, fuel pump. It's been almost 4 years with about a year off in between.
What do you want to do with this?
Fundraising and charity. I myself went through about with testicular cancer a little over 2 years ago at this point. And I just like to be able to make sure that anybody who has any charity or fundraising events that needs help or a boost, and to be able to see this from the street and, oh my gosh, I'd like to donate to your cause, you know, that, because this thing rubbernecks people.
Yeah.
So just anything to be able to help out with that. That's all it's for.
All right, so Brian still has a few more things to do to make his big black car legal to drive on the street, but he says you'll probably never see him driving. He's too afraid that it's going to cause accidents if he drives it down the street, too many people looking at it as he's driving by. But he just wants to use it for all those charitable causes, to spread joy to people and that kind of thing. So
that's awesome.
That was really neat. So, big thanks for him for reaching out and having us out.
Nice. Thanks Marcus. Guys.